as soon as you employ this process, you start to see that you're able to eat much larger quantities of carbohydrate coming from fresh fruits and fresh vegetables for smaller insulin use. I'll repeat that. More carbohydrate for less insulin. And we just got back from one of our retreats. We hold these retreats a couple of times per year. And it's an opportunity for people with type 1 diabetes, type 1.5 diabetes, pre-diabetes, and type 2 diabetes to come together and learn about the power of low-fat, plant-based, whole food nutrition for significant improvements in insulin sensitivity. And we've held multiple of these retreats before. And every single time, we're able to promote a significant improvement in blood glucose values, a reduction in insulin use, and a reduction in insulin sensitizing oral medication. And we do it using the power of food. Now, at our latest retreat, we had a total of 14 people living with diabetes, 7 of whom were living with insulin-dependent diabetes. Now, in this article, we're going to go into detail about the results that each one of these people achieved in improving their insulin sensitivity in as little as 4 days. That's right. We arrive on Thursday. We're there all day Friday, all day Saturday, all day Sunday, and you go home on Monday. And you would think to yourself, well, in 4 days, how much positive change can you really get in improving your insulin sensitivity? Take a look below at the results that each one of our insulin-dependent diabetics achieved. Now, let's go into a little bit of detail here in understanding what is insulin sensitivity. In the world of low-carbohydrate nutrition, what you'll be told over and over and over again is that the only thing that matters is how much insulin you're using per day. That's why all of the literature out there is showing you how to minimize your carbohydrate intake so that you can minimize your insulin use. In the world of insulin sensitivity, however, your insulin use is just one variable. The other variable, which you have to take into account, is your total carbohydrate consumption. Insulin sensitivity is defined as your total carbohydrate intake divided by your total insulin use in a span of 24 hours. And in this Mastering Diabetes retreat, what we do is we teach people how to migrate towards a low-fat diet, because as soon as you achieve a low-fat diet, then the amount of carbohydrate that you can consume, that your body can tolerate, that your digestive system and muscles and liver can metabolize, starts to go up. So that means less fat, more carbohydrate. So as soon as you employ this process, you start to see that you're able to eat much larger quantities of carbohydrate coming from fresh fruits and fresh vegetables for smaller insulin use. I'll repeat that. More carbohydrate for less insulin. Now, our first retreat attendee attended the retreat eating 150 grams of carbohydrate in her previous diet. And she used a total of 88.2 units of insulin, which means that her 24-hour insulin sensitivity was about a 1.7. During the retreat, we instructed her to increase her carbohydrate intake while reducing her fat intake. She was able to consume an average of 257 grams of carbohydrate, and her insulin use fell to 58.6 units for a 24-hour insulin sensitivity of 4.4. So you can see that her change in insulin sensitivity over this 4-day period was 258%. This is what happened in the first 4 days. Imagine what happens as soon as she returns to her normal life and continues this approach. Her insulin use is likely to continue falling, and her carbohydrate intake is likely to continue increasing as she controls her blood glucose with more and more precision. Now, our second attendee increased her insulin sensitivity by a total of 309%, and she did this by increasing her carbohydrate intake only by about 50 grams per day. But as you can see, her total insulin use went from 50 units per day all the way down to 22 units per day. So what that means is that she's eating more carbohydrate, but she cut her insulin use in half in only a 4-day period. And as a result of that, her insulin sensitivity increased by a total of 309%. The third person increased her carbohydrate intake from an average of about 200 grams per day all the way up to about 300 grams per day. And in this process, she also cut her insulin use by 50%. You can see here, she started out using a total of 60 units per day, divided about in half between basal and bolus, and reduced it all the way down to 30 units per day. As a result, she increased her insulin sensitivity by a total of 299%. Our next attendee increased her carbohydrate intake by twofold. In other words, she started to eat double the amount of carbohydrate that she ate when she previously came, 208 grams versus about 110 grams previously. As a result of that, her insulin use fell from 43.6 units per day all the way down to 27.6 units per day, giving her an increase in her total insulin sensitivity of about 162%. This gentleman increased his carbohydrate intake from 275 grams per day all the way up to 422 grams per day. And in the process, he was able to cut about 8 units of insulin off of his standard baseline of 37 units per day. What that means is that his insulin sensitivity went from a 7.4 all the way to a 14.4, which is a change of about 193%. Our next attendee increased her carbohydrate intake by about 50%. She went from about 100 grams per day to about 142 grams per day. Now you'll notice here that her insulin use actually slightly went up. And the reason for that is simple. Before she came to the retreat, she was using only basal insulin, 0 bolus units per day. In the retreat, we showed her how to decrease her basal use of insulin. And in the process, she found that she needed a little bit more bolus insulin. So her total insulin use actually climbed from 18 units per day to about 23 units per day. Despite that slight increase in her insulin usage, her insulin sensitivity still went up. So in the first 4 days, she noticed about 111% increase in her insulin sensitivity. So you can see in each of these situations how adopting a low-fat, plant-based, whole foods approach makes significant changes in a very short period of time. Now, each of these attendees has gone back to their life, has gone back to their daily routine, but done so by changing the food that they're eating and changing their movement patterns according to what they learned while at the retreat. What you're looking at here is just the tip of the tip of the tip of the iceberg. Because this 4-day period for a lot of these individuals is just a launching point into a brand new lifestyle that leads to improved insulin sensitivity over the course of time. Now, we like to talk about the fact that this is just biology. We understand the biology of diabetes and insulin resistance better than most people. And as a result of that, simply by integrating a low-fat, plant-based, whole foods approach, we can see dramatic differences in a short period of time that then lead to dramatic differences in the long term. Now, whether you're interested in participating in a coaching program, showing up to one of our retreats, or just doing this on your own, the world is your oyster. Keep in touch with us, let us know how we can help you, and we hope that we can get the same results for you that you saw for all the other retreat attendees. Thanks for listening.